Maddie, I feel like Elsie. I feel that I admire a lot of women. There's so many amazing women out there. But if I also had to choose one, I would choose Pura Belpre. Pura Belpre was the first Latina librarian to work in the New York public library system. And this was in the 1920s when the United States was going through the Great Depression. So a lot of people needed library services as they still need them today. But that time was really hard for a lot of people, and especially for a lot of immigrants and children of the immigrants who were coming to the United States and didn't know English. So as they learn English, there was nothing to read in their native language. So Pura Belpre, native from Puerto Rico, noticed that there was no Spanish books for children. So one day she just sat down and wrote them herself, and she actually became the first Latina to ever in history have published children books with a mainstream publisher. That's very rad right there. And another thing very incredible that she did was to take books outside of the library and go to anywhere from Harlem to the Bronx to Brooklyn to read to the kids in the streets. So she took the library to the streets, to the community, and that makes her an incredible rad woman.
My rad woman is Whoopi Goldberg. You gotta be rad to rename yourself Whoopi.
But since I've been here back in San Helena, where I grew up, there's a woman that really inspired me when I was young here, Donna McCormick. She was my teacher and my coach here at San Helena High School. And she inspired me to embrace my athletic ability and my athletic self. She came to the school and she was very young and fit and strong and confident, and I aspired to that. And she was on the cutting edge of Title IX, which is equal access to athletics for girls, and that was just starting then. And so she got us all involved in athletics, and she really inspired me to try to lead a healthy lifestyle. And every day I try to be active and make good healthy choices, and I thank Donna for that.
Este valle, yo creo que las mujeres que yo más admiro son las mujeres que trabajan en el campo, que se tienen que levantar muy temprano y preparar todo para que sus hijos se vayan a la escuela y luego ellas irse a trabajar al campo, trabajar entre 8 y 10 horas diarias, regresar a sus casas y todavía seguir con sus responsabilidades del hogar, ser mamá, ser esposas, ser hijas. Y para mí esas son personas, son mujeres que merecen todo mi respeto y admiración, porque se necesita mucha energía y pasión para, y pues tal vez muchos lo hacen por necesidad, ¿verdad? Pero para trabajar en esos trabajos tan duros aquí en el valle.
She was very brave after the death of her husband and wrote about her experience, which to me is a manifesto of grief. I still think Michelle Obama, but in this day and age, yeah.
Who?
All the women I work with.
Yay!
Run the ship. There are no men. Except for our kind and very generous with their time volunteers.
There are so many women who have influenced me and who have inspired me. There's so many famous women like Eleanor Roosevelt, but one of the ones closest to me who inspired me is my Aunt Lucy. I miss her every day. She was a person who was so independent and had lived through so much. She was an incredible person with the biggest heart. Career-wise, a person who influenced me a lot is Clayla Davis, who was the library director here. She was influential in mentoring me, and she was just a wonderful person who believed in the library so much.
Hola, me llamo Norma Ferriz, y yo quiero compartir que la mujer revolucionaria que me ha inspirado se llama Amelia Earhart. Ella fue una de las primeras mujeres que fue piloto y que trató de dar la vuelta al mundo en su avión sola. Finalmente no pudo, pero realmente ella siempre trató y dio lo mejor de ella.
Hey,
admire most is my mom, because she's always there for me, and she's worked really hard to be where she is, and I'm really proud of her. So she inspires me to work hard for myself.
The woman I admire most has to be the one who's personally shaped my life. Has to be Selena Quintanilla, who was a famous pop star in Tejana. I think she's admirable because she managed to, how do you say, embrace her Mexican-American culture. And she wasn't afraid to, like, stand out. And I admire her feminist sentiments.
Take two.
Take two, Maddie. Who's the woman that you admire the most?
I admire Alice Paul the most because she fought for our right to vote, and she was constantly concerned about the future instead of her own circumstances.
A woman that I admire is Maya Angelou, and I admire her because she was bold enough to speak out in a time of oppression about sexual abuse and make a name for herself, and she was a really beautiful, powerful woman.
The woman that I admire the most is Fergie, because she has a great talent of singing, and she is very unique in many different ways, and I mostly like her in the Black Eyed Peas, and my favorite song from her is Glamorous.
I chose Ruth Bader Ginsburg because she has worked her entire life to protect and support women, and she worked in gender issues, and she's the first person in 1971 in Reed versus Reed who applied the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment to extend to gender issues and sex discrimination, which I think is amazing. And she has made a difference in our country by supporting our democratic principles and being supportive of everyone, and I admire her greatly and hope she can continue on the Supreme Court. Thank you.
Hi, a woman that I really look up to is Vernice Armour. She's the first African-American female naval pilot in the Marine Corps, and she's also the first African-American female combat pilot in the entire U.S. Armed Forces. So this is really cool. Really important. She opens a lot of doors for a lot of females to achieve, accomplish a lot of things in the military. Her valor, her power. She's great. A lot of respect to her. Thanks.
Hi, my name is Nanny, and one of the women that I most admire is La Comandante Ramona. She was an essential member of the Zapatista Army of National Liberation. She also has a very peculiar story. She was a woman who was considered to be fragile and poor, but that did not stop her. In time, she became one of the most powerful women in the Mexican Revolution. While alive, and even after her death, this Zapatista revolutionary woman continues to be an example of self-empowerment, self-respect, and even an example of what women can achieve when they aim for it.
Well, I mean, I admire lots of them, but for right now, I really admire Maya Angelou.
Ooh, wow.
Who was an incredible poet, dancer, singer, single mom, civil rights activist, and just a really awe-inspiring woman all around.
Hi, my rad woman is my daughter, Camille. She is the most fiercest, bravest, courageous girl, woman, almost woman, that I know.